starts off with how was your weekend?
Okay, yeah, I watch them all the time. Yeah, it was really good. I had a lot of fun this weekend. I wish we could have did a bit more riding yesterday, but the weather was a little bit too wet, so I think they did a really great job of the track. Today it was really technical, and yeah, today had a heap of fun, got two decent starts and made my way to the front, and yeah, the boys were pushing at me there for a while, but track was really rough and technical, and yeah, it was nice, like had a nice flow to it, and you had to stay on the pegs and whatnot, so yeah. It was a cool weekend, 1-1. It's first time I've won a race in a long time, so it actually feels pretty good.
Yeah, so you said the track was a little technical, but it was kind of like sticky, muddy in the middle.
Yeah, yeah.
How did the track here compare to tracks in Australia or Europe where you raced last year?
Yeah, well, there's actually a track exactly like this in Australia. It's called Toowoomba. Uh-huh. And always for the MX Nationals, they overwater it in the morning. So it's like slick and like really that, like heavy dirt,
yeah.
And by the end of the day, it's really good and has those like kind of blue groove slick spots. So yeah, it just, the hills aren't probably as big as Toowoomba, but everything else is exactly the same. Yeah. And I like, normally I don't go really good at Toowoomba, but I like the track there. Uh-huh. So it was, yeah, heap of fun.
I noticed your technique today was a lot of standing up, like in the corners and stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
That's how you have to kind of ride those conditions?
Yeah, well, that's how I like to ride anyway. Yeah, I kind of always watch Kenny in that ride, and he's always on the pegs, and I try to do that. I like to be a bit smoother like that and try to use my legs as a bit of suspension. Mm-hmm. And I find, yeah, to be honest, my ass gets sore if I sit down for too long on those acceleration bumps, so you got to stand up a bit more.
Right. All right, it seems like Honda brings a rider over, whether it's from the GPs or US, to the finale. It's kind of a tradition. So when did you find out you were selected, and were you pumped about it?
Yeah, so I found out probably July, August kind of thing, because I knew Tim was going to do the Monster Cup.
Yeah.
And normally he would come and do this, so they had no one, and they said, oh, you want to go? And I said, hell yeah. I always wanted to come to Japan, and I was actually planning with my best mate to come for New Year's and go snowboarding and whatnot. So,
nice.
But I got to come here instead. I love the people here and I love the food here, so it's been a good week.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that. Was the food easy or was it kind of scary? Or?
Nah, it's easy. You know, it's funny because my favorite restaurant back in my hometown in Australia is called Tokyo Dumpling, and I go there at least once a week. And because I'm not going to be back home in Australia for a while, the last night I actually went and had Tokyo Dumpling there, and Mum's like, why are you going there? You're going to Japan for a week, you're going to get that food all week. But I said, oh, it's still good, so I had to go there.
That's cool. Did you try anything new?
Yeah,
this trip?
I tried beef tongue and pig tongue and intestines.
Oh,
yeah,
what'd you
think? Taka got me to try it.
Oh,
and, The beef tongue was okay, pig tongue no good, and the intestines,
yeah, they smell, huh?
Yeah.
I think Taka got me to eat horse one time.
Yeah, I love horse.
Yeah?
In Italy, yeah, it's like at every restaurant, and I tried it for the first time this year, and I loved it.
Nice, nice.
Thank you.
Did you get to do anything else in Japan? Like, I think Sealy went to Motegi.
Yeah. On Friday, we got to go to, well, Thursday afternoon, I got to go to HRC headquarters and have a look around there. So that was pretty cool. I got to see like the rally bikes and whatnot. And then, yeah, Friday we stopped in at Motegi, and that was pretty cool to see the history there.
So I texted Hunter Lawrence last night. Is Mitch your mate? And he goes, totally, we grew up racing juniors together.
Yeah, we always grew up racing each other. And he was, because he's a bit younger than me, he was always like that little bit like chasing us kind of thing. Wilson Todd and I were always battling. And yeah, but we're great family friends. And yeah, he's cool. It's cool to see, like, we all grew up racing each other and now we're all overseas, so it's cool to see that we're all got there, because when we were younger, that's all we would talk about, you know, wanting to get over. So it's cool to see it come about now.
Yeah, so Hunter went the GP route.
Yep.
He was on the same 114 Honda team, and it was kind of like you're following his footsteps a little.
Yeah, a little bit, I guess.
Did your goal to come to the US ultimately?
When I was younger, yeah, it was for sure, and I still like doing Supercross, and when I was younger, I always thought, oh yeah, I want to go to America because the culture's the same, and you know, no language barriers or whatnot. But this year I really enjoyed my time in Europe, so it's kind of like now I don't know which way I want to go, but yeah, I would love to go see America and give Supercross a go, so yeah, maybe one day you'll see me there.
Cool. Right on, man. Congrats on the win.
Thank you.
それでは、両手台の皆さんにちょっとお話しします。